Please be seated. Four centuries ago, John Napier of Merkeston, from whom this university proudly takes its name, invented logarithms, one of the greatest contributions to the advancement of knowledge. It was a great step which underpinned Kepler's work on the orbit of the planets and Newton's theory of gravity. Today you, Edinburgh Napier's newest graduates, take your own step. History records the support and encouragement to work and study that John Napier received through his faith, from his family and friends, and from those who read his work. We share today's joy with those who have helped us reach this step. And so I invite you to begin today's ceremony with a moment's reflection to give thanks for the support we have received and the strength we have been given by others. I declare our graduation ceremony open. Now, prior to this, I was standing up in here watching the photographer, Alan, who's a dear friend of mine, winding you guys all up, and I thought that's a hard act to follow. So here we go. I'm not here to lecture you today. You're probably sick of that. I am here to confer upon you your degree and wish you well. I'm also here to offer some advice for what it's worth. And if someone ever tells you your dreams are impossible, then wish them well and tell them perhaps theirs is, but not yours. The reality is, none of us really know what tomorrow holds. What I can tell you for sure is you'll never achieve your dreams if you don't try and achieve them. Dreams are important, but no more so than the road trying to find them. In terms of physical miles, I grew up not too far from here. In terms of me ever thinking I would be standing on this stage in front of you all, well, that was another world away, and a dream I could never have imagined. We never cease to learn so long as our minds and hearts are open, and often our classroom of tomorrow has no walls. I like to tell the story someone unknown taught me. A few years ago, as I was walking down 10th Avenue in New York, I passed a construction site, and scribbled on the board was a little piece of graffiti. I can't credit the author's wisdom or their name, as they chose to remain anonymous. And whilst I've adapted their scribble to suit my purpose today, I hope I do so with their blessing, as I believe we have similar hopes. This is a scribble, and I have replaced the word dreams and success. This is what most folk hope for, but here's the reality. This made me smile, but also made me think. If the scribble on the left was a reality, I think it would disappoint most of you. Not immediately, perhaps, but eventually. It's hard to believe, but let me tell you why. The little bundle of chaos on the right, the confusing bit, well, that's where the magic really happens. That's the part of the journey in front of you that you can't even begin to imagine today. But funnily, it's often the most important part of the journey. It looks confusing and chaotic, and much of it is. But don't fear it, never underestimate it or its value. For it houses a special part of the journey that lies before you. It's important because it's where you'll find your wildest dreams. The ones today that you cannot even begin to imagine. And take my word, they're even better than the ones you can. Please try to remember this when all seems lost, and from time to time it will. But never stop trying, for it will unravel itself one day, I'm sure. I'm also sure, well, I hope, you all want to go and congratulate one another, share some smiles, a couple of selfies, and a few drinks. And for me to keep this speech as short as possible. But please take one extra little moment today and think of all the people in this world and the dreams so many of them can only ever imagine. For many millions, their dream would be to sit on the very seats you're sitting on in anticipation of what you're about to receive. For some folk, they can only ever dream of education and sitting where you are at this very moment in time. Enjoy and cherish this moment. Today is about you, tomorrow even more so. Today is the start of what is a relatively short journey, so don't waste your time worrying or being fearful of failure only fear not trying. Failure can often be the greatest contributor to a person's success. And never stop dreaming. And I hope along this road, you like me one day, experience your wildest dreams. I stand here, humbled and proud before each and every single one of you as testament to their existence. Share your moments and encourage others to dream. Who knows, they may even become part of your dream. My hopes are not for you to change the world. The world will take care of itself. My hopes are you'll respect it, enrich it, and support it. Experience will feed you like little else you'll encounter. Share experience and wisdom with others. Enjoy this day, and to each and every single one of you, congratulations and well done. I now introduce the conferment on the Honorary Award.
Chancellor, it is my privilege to present Professor Lesley Yellowlees for the honorary degree of Doctor of Science. Professor Yellowlees is Vice Principal and Head of the College of Science and Engineering at the University of Edinburgh and Professor of Inorganic Electrochemistry. She's an expert in spectroelectrochemistry techniques, having developed a distinctive and a world-renowned body of research in this area. In this work, she's mapped compounds that can be used in solar energy cells. In addition, her techniques have been adopted by scientists across the world for many different purposes, from the development of drugs that fight cancer to the extraction of precious metals from waste. Now, Professor Yellowlees was born in London, but when she was 9, she moved to Edinburgh with her family. She enjoyed sciences at school, but when the time came to make her university applications, she faced a dilemma: which science to choose. Chemical physics proved the attractive option because it allowed her to pursue her interest in both chemistry and physics. For most of her career, Professor Yellowlees has worked in Scotland, apart from a short period when she worked at the University of Queensland in Brisbane, Australia. She is well known for her contributions to the wider community in chemistry, both as the past president of the Royal Society of Chemistry and also as a strong advocate for women in science and engineering. Her career is one of pioneering firsts. She was awarded a first-class degree in chemical physics from the University of Edinburgh in 1975, and she also happened to be the only female student in her year group. She was the first ever female head of chemistry at Edinburgh and also the first ever female vice principal of science and engineering at Edinburgh University. She was also the first ever female president of the Royal Society of Chemistry after 171 years of waiting. And she was one of the first in 2005 to champion the Athena Swan Charter. This is a charter that's been set up to encourage and recognise commitment to the advancing of careers of women in science, technology, engineering, maths and medicine, and also their employment in higher education and research. Finally, I believe she's the only chemist who has ever worn a red taffeta ball gown in the lab. The School of Chemistry at Edinburgh is also the first academic department in Scotland to hold an Athena Swan Gold Award. This has much to do with the foundations for supporting the careers of women that Professor Yellowlees put down a decade ago when leading the school as its head. I would love to say that she's here to be awarded her first honorary doctorate, however, this is actually her second. Professor Yellowlees' achievements have also been recognized in a number of fellowships, from the Royal Society of Chemistry, the Institute of Physics, and the Royal Society of Edinburgh. She holds an MBA for her services to science, and she was awarded the CBE in the 2014 New Year's Honours for services to chemistry. Professor Yellowlees has stated publicly in the past that the best day of the academic year is graduation day. She loves seeing everyone, including the parents, family members, friends, proudly supporting the smart new graduates in their new shoes, all gathered together for formal recognition of their academic achievements. Today we are delighted we're able to celebrate the work of Professor Yellowlees alongside that of our own Edinburgh Napier graduates. Chancellor, in recognition of her major contribution to chemistry and her pioneering work to promote women in science, I invite you to confer on Professor Lesley Yellowlees the honorary degree of Doctor of Science.
Chancellor, staff, students, and friends of Edinburgh Napier University, thank you very much indeed for bestowing on me this honorary degree. It is a pleasure and a privilege to accept it. Pleasure because who doesn't love a great celebration surrounded by those we love? And a privilege because receiving a degree from this fine university is a rare and precious thing, especially when you don't have to sit an exam to get one. This is a wonderful occasion. As Hazel says, I love graduation ceremonies, and I love seeing everyone dressed up in their gowns, surrounded by supporters, bursting with pride. And I love all the attendant celebrations. As an honorary graduate, I get the privilege of 2 minutes of your time. So firstly, I would like to thank, on your and my behalf, all those who have helped us arrive here today. In my case, a very big thank you to my husband Peter and my mother Jean, who are both here today. Thank you for your love and encouragement over the years. To the University of Edinburgh and the Royal Society of Chemistry for giving me opportunities and support, and to my long-suffering students. On your behalf, a very big and public thank you to everyone who has got us here. We couldn't have done it without you. Secondly, thank you, Hazel, for all the nice things you said about me. I never set out to become president of the Royal Society of Chemistry or vice principal and head of the College of Science and Engineering at the University of Edinburgh. And to be the first woman to hold both positions is staggering. However, when the opportunities arose, I took them and have never regretted so doing. So often today, we, and women in particular, are encouraged to learn to say no. But I would urge you to look for opportunities. Grasp them with both hands and not be afraid to say yes. My guiding principle has been to never look back and wish I'd done something. I've enjoyed the best of times. And occasionally, when it doesn't work out, I learn and move on. I've used my firsts to speak positively about women in science, technology, engineering, and maths, that is STEM, because in my experience, you can have a wonderful, satisfying, productive life and career in STEM, regardless of your gender. I certainly have. However, women, especially in senior positions, are in a minority. They need role models and support. And that's one reason why I'm particularly delighted to accept this degree from Edinburgh Napier. You have the best of role models in your principal, Professor Andrea Nolan. and the university has a Bronze Athena Swan Award in recognition of your commitment to advancing the careers of women in STEM. I would also want to acknowledge Edinburgh Napier's prominent role in Scotland in hosting Equate, who are leaders in gender equality. In conclusion then, remember your time at Edinburgh Napier University with pride and affection. Remember, Edinburgh Napier University will always be here for you. Support it, and it will always be here to support you. So tomorrow, or the next day, depending on how well you celebrate tonight, you will look to your future. Embrace it as a wonderful opportunity, and don't waste too much of it. Decide what success means to you, and go for it. Work hard, but remember to stop sometimes and smell the roses. They can smell very sweet. Congratulations to you all. Thank you.
I'm now delighted to introduce our musical interlude performed by our music students. Beat Not So Hard My Heart, written for soprano and ensemble. The music is by Kenneth Dempster, words by Jenga Saner. And this aria was composed in 2004 to mark the 70th birthday of our honorary doctorate, Sir Peter Maxwell Davies, who sadly passed away in March of this year.
Please, one, south. Chancellor, I'm pleased to present students for the following awards. For the award of Master by Research for a programme of work entitled The Combined Effect of High Intensity Intermittent Training and Vitamin D Supplementation on Insulin Sensitivity in Overweight and Obese Males and Females, Hannah Margaret Lithgow. For the award of Doctor of Philosophy for the programme of work entitled The Influence of Age, Cardiorespiratory Fitness, Exercise and Sedentary Behaviours on Circulating Angiogenic Cells and Cell Surface Receptor Expression, Mark Ross. Chancellor, I'm pleased to present students from the School of Life, Sport and Social Sciences. Ayla May McLeod. Winner of the University Medal, Anna Oskka. Freya Skrosen. Sunara Jane Barber. Jamie Marie Boyd. Amy Gardner. Claire Michelle Higgins. Simone McDonald. Devon Ashley McKenzie. Ruby Iris Merriman. Sarah Miller. Rebecca Ann Moyer. Rebecca Potts. Fraser Andrew Robertson. Elliot Dale Watson. Emma Jane Wilson. James Russell Zahn. Zachary Boyd. Sophie Jean Davidson. Nicola Glenn. Karen Caldwell Monroe. Andrew Palmer. Catherine Elizabeth White. Charlotte Harriet Mayer. Charlotte Amber Davy. Kelly Ann Patrick. Chloe Mitchell. Winner of the University Medal, Emma Murray. Benjamin Smith. Leslie Wong. Beth Chapman. Emma Dawson. Simone Jade Duddy. Julie Fortune. Rebecca Murdoch. Gregor Sim. Rebecca Hannah Roberts. Winner of the University Medal, Matthew McBain. Scott David Graham. Gillian Quinn. Emily Adams. Amy Elsby. Chloe Tamin Gilver. Winner of the University Medal, winner of the Lawrence Ho Student Prize, winner of the Society of Biology Top Student Award, Miguel Hernandez Madrigal. Benjamin Stewart Kirkley Kelly. Megan Elizabeth Brown. Stephen David Brunt. Ailey Cranson. Benjamin Andrew Crawford. Lee Davidson. Daisy Fortuna Atia. Gemma Page Hinch. Ami Onishi. Connor John Stevenson. Hannah Bisbee. Thomas Henry Powell. Kaylee Louise Margaret Simpson. Freya Stewart. Yasashwi Kalipini Pereira Vihantaj. Marcus Aloni. Maria Luisa Cobos. Candace Elizabeth Mary Stevens. Amelie Barbara Babert. Bronya Jane Denton. Vary Louise Scott Bennett. Carol Simpson. Gillian Smith. Megan Welsh. Daniela Dragomir. Joanne Marie Holmes. Graham Kidd. Julie Littredo. Antonia Palmer. Jane Porter. Susan Ritchie. Victoria Ross. Linda Helen Smith. Iris Cordula Duca. Winner of the University Medal, Larissa Engelman. Paris Omonia. Beth Anna Barclay. Graham Boyd. Nikki Bryce. Stephanie Jane Caddle. Abby Campbell. Nicole Diane Clifford. Alexandra Curtis. Joshua James Doctor. Jessica Hannah Evans. Amy Grant. Callum Alexander Stephen Grant. Lee Groves. Kaylee Kerrigan. Rihanna King. Jordan McFarlane. Arthur Martin. Sarah Catherine McGarry. Estelle McLean. Sarah Louise Redpath. Christopher Mark Roberts. Rebecca Louise Smith. Amy Louise Taylor. Noura Susanna Vlaminka. Gary Paul Verth. Callum Andrew Welsh. Katie Ann Young. Nicola Rebecca Young. Laura Louise Ainsley. Kayleigh McNeil. Sean Thompson. Rachel Tinkler. Madeline Whelan. Emma Wright. Carolyn Balfour Kemp. Andrew McCulley. Charlotte Barker. Winner of the University Medal, Adam Michael Robert Hall. Deborah Elizabeth McFarlane. Angela Bahuiz. Lily Clark. Alexander Lawrence. Colin Miller. Remy Rien Henry Huang Bailey. Ellen Scott. Winner of the University Medal, Barry Joan Doherty. Amy Louise Cunningham. Kaylee Ann Davidson. Aileen Margaret Freer. Laura Hutchison. Nicole Johnson. Winner of the University Medal, Laura McKay. Alistair David Maltman. Megan Catherine Smith. Roisin Stout. Jennifer Mary Henderson. Gemma Wilson. Jacqueline Marie Johnson. Alban Mazar Simon. Sarah Moon. Elika Anna Wolf. Jamie Bruce. Delhi Lee Ann Woodhead. Winner of the Lawrence Ho Student Prize, winner of the University Medal, winner of the Industrial Research Award, Madara Lang. Ruben Arndt Rosendorf. Rochelle Berwick. Lorraine Dudon. Amy Peters. Zohab Zahib. Abby Riley. Oluwatani Adabo Jedreg. Christiana Olavafan Malerio Ayasanaji. Murdo Anderson. Jonas Zimmermanis. Emma Catherine Dowds. Asha Manir. Winner of the University Medal, Emma McCune. Nadia Hernandez Plum. Winner of the British Psychological Society Award, Stephanie Louise Taylor. Delara Alharverdi. Robin Hannah Marie Anderson. Sarah Elizabeth Ariza. Sophie Bates. Chloe Elizabeth Campbell. Fraser James McFarlane Campbell. Laura Cunningham. Elana Sarah Dean. Gemma Louise Dickinson. Catriona Margaret Dougal. Andrew Ian McMaster Gray. Lydia Jones. David John Masson. Louise Audrey McCann. Selena Marie McPherson. Penny Ann O'Brien. Natasha Richardson. Jessica Jane Smith. Jake Ferguson. Alana Christina Mason. Danielle McConnell. Diana Miller. Amy Sarah Louise Sutherland. Kirsty Wilson. Holly Marsh. Elsa Leslie. Saskia Kemp. Winner of the University Medal, Emma Campbell Smith. Ashley Beaton. Benjamin Conte. Erin O'Rourke Gorey. Rebecca Hunter. Jessica Hurst. Sarah Marshall. Claire Shanks. Ross David Stewart. Natalie Kate Marr. Sunita Singh. Rebecca Gamble. Lisa Marie Pavich King. Winner of the University Medal, winner of the Howard Woolman Honours Project Medal, Luke Power. Winner of the Howard Woolman Honours Project Medal, Alexandra Buchanan Stevens. Lisa Ruth Catherine Campbell. Charlotte Clark. Alison Marianne Codron. Craig Copeland. Grant Denham. Claire Donnelly. Carly Douglas. Christopher Finlay. Jennifer Gibson. Kirsten Goodall. Andrew Hay. Robert John Hudson. Jack Thomas Alistair Laidlaw. Lucy Logan. Gemma Louise Sarah Macbeth. Henry Prince. Fraser William Simpson. Nicola Stewart. Lisa Strachan. Reese Thompson. Winnie Wegner. Kirsten Stephanie White. Matthew Conrad Thomas Whitten. Lauren Mary Wright. Hannah Louise Edgecombe. Catherine Elizabeth Ferguson. Lauren Holt. Kyson Lee. Caroline Cecilia Lewis. Nicole Linton. Tonderia Makina Martin. Michael McMullen. Ainsley Elizabeth Motherwell. Alistair Renton. Ning Tung Wong. Sarah Megan Brown. Amy Matheson. Winner of the University Medal, Catherine Allison Long. James Ashworth. Daniel Duffy. Jamie William Braithwaite. Jack Cam. Jonathan Gordon. Callum Harvey. Ewan McGonnell. Jessica Louise Reid. Kieran Smith. Charles Michael Carstairs. King Fei Shung. Craig Cubitt. Rhys James Davies. David Gordon. Joshua James Moncrief Haining. Rebecca Nicola Hardy. Andrew Harrison. Catriona Elizabeth McKenzie. Laurie McIlpop. Hayley Rachel Monteith. Catriona Morton. Liam Jake Newman. Connor Patterson. Shannon Georgia Quinn. Jack Graham Renison. Kieran Gavin Schooler. Helena Susan Sheriffs. Rory Maxwell-Tolls. Rachel Walkinshaw. Jordan Rhys-Williams. Charles Dennis Winton. Gillian Carney. Alistair Donnelly. Tony Michael James. Ross Landell Johnson. Cameron Leask. Ryan Lewis. Callum Ross McDonald. Fern Margaret Mitchell. Kylie Francis Semple. Oh, Kyle. Rory Derek Stewart. Jessica Sutherland Wilkie. Caitlin Donald. Jack Laurie. Christopher Neil Beatty. Andrew John McGregor. Grant McLeod. Sarah Marie O'Connell. Reginald Foreman. Katarzyna Globiska. Rachel Doherty. Lorna Essen. Danielle Anna Gilmore. Alan Hay. Harry Rowan Jeffcoat. Paul Anthony Keane. Jennifer Kirsty Lennonson. Jade Armstrong. Christopher David Ashworth. Robert Griffin. Darren Miller. Duncan Morrison. Louise Corr. Andrew Brown. Grace Day. Ailey Fletcher. Danielle Hudson. James Jobson. Janine McDonald. Jamie Lee Simmons. Danielle Yvette Tatton. Emma Louise Walker. Shannon Wilson. Ryan Bro. Victoria Dorinsko. Claire Frances Norrie. Jenna Pringle. Alistair Robertson. Johan James Van Kessel. Rory Clinch. Yeah! Lauren Nadine Soden. Robin Bonner. Grace Sarah Cameron. Jennifer Leslie Cowan. Catherine Louise Finlayson. Katie Christine Galloway. Julia Marion Elizabeth White Hume. Neil Kemp. Josie J. McBride. Winner of the University Medal, Rachel Maria Sikora. Lauren Thompson. Karen Aitchison. Emma Flockert. Caitlin Penny Forbes. Tanya Leanne Keane. Suzanne Kerr. Hannah Alexandria McDonald. Robin McKee. Claire McKenna. Christina Mitchell. Stacey Lee Patterson. Nicola May Pride. Laurie Christina Shearer. Holly Natasha Simpson. Megan Rose Smith. Isla Sarah Sutton. Nicole Jamie Thompson. Alexandra Beth Yarnell. Sarah Gemmel. Martin George McAndrew. Nicola Jane McKenzie. Ashley Lauren Sutton. Winner of the University Medal, Neil Diamond. Winner of the University Medal, James Graham Easton. Suzanne Muir. Chancellor, I now call upon the Dean of Nursing, Midwifery and Social Care.
Chancellor, I am pleased to present students from the School of Nursing, Midwifery and Social Care for the following awards. Hannah Brennan. Elizabeth Mary Brown. Catherine Colette Crowley. Michelle Curtin. Donna Marie Doherty. Emma Ann Duffy. Laura Mary Fenney. John Ferris. Amy Gilfillan. Neve Bridget Green. Lee Elizabeth Heron. Jordan Elizabeth Christine Hutchison. Megan Catherine Janskowski. Darina Kerr. Kirsty Shirley Kitchen. Kerry Jane Matthews. Christina Maria May. Winner of the University Medal, Sarah Louise McKim. Joseph Mearns. Mary Keelan Murphy. Horik John Nash. Winner of the University Medal, Sarah Jane O'Neill. Marie Catherine Ryan. Goody Joy Shalomi. Geraldine Mary Smith. Jessica Teasdale. Ruth Marion Affleck. Favour Maureen Adja. Marilyn Cole. Denise Goretti Collins. Erin Joy Craig. Kira Geraldine Devaney. Winner of the Susie Connell Prize, Irene Drury. Sarah Claire Dugan. Amy Rachel Galvin. Amy Teresa Gillespie. Erin Jade Gallogly. Rasheen Ann Gordon. Gary Hovell. Joanna Malgozata Keita. Kirsty McKee. Lisa Marie Devaney. Michael Miller McLean. Kelly Marie O'Sullivan. Monica Bagani. Louise Scott. Kelly Gail Seaton. Amanda Jane Sorley. Monica Staromlinska. Laura Catherine Taylor. Coral Thompson. Lindsay Tilbrook. Lindsay Wood. Don Buchan. Leslie Sharkey. Jennifer Carol Muir. Gillian Margaret Reed. Ellen Zananika. Claire Bryant. Udoka Chinwenju Ihizi. Faustina Femi Ogrobetu. Christine Curtis. Rachel Louise Diane Doherty. Anna Margaret Williams. Julie Helen Grant. Joanna Janek. Jacqueline Tayuba Abizi McKendrick. Lisa Cairns. Emma Hare. Winner of the University Medal, Harriet Rebecca Randall. Aoife Marie Sherlock. Mohamed Karolo Nasran Ahmad Akia. Siti Salbia Amin. Diana Shikara. Mary Ann Fairman Macalamino. Omuwana Olabide Bankole. Wendy Sharon Connolly. Glennis McIntosh. Elizabeth Ann Shewald. Sarah Shahi A. Alshia. Donna Madeline McNeil. Natalia Monde Zulu Naluvu. Jennifer Louise Rice. Maureen Christine Smith. Linda Gunn. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of students from the School of Nursing, Midwifery and Social Care.
Would the graduates please stand? By the powers vested in me by the University Court and Academic Board of Edinburgh Napier University, I confer the awards for which you have been presented today. For those eligible for an award but unable to attend today's ceremony, I am pleased to confer the awards in absentia. Many congratulations to you all. Please be seated.
Good afternoon, Chancellor, Court, Vice-Chancellor, Academic Board, guests, ladies and gentlemen, graduates. A very warm welcome to you all. I'm very honored to be able to share this incredible experience with you all today as your ENSAR student president. The ceremony marks a huge achievement and milestone in your lives, and you should all be really proud of where you are today. All of you here today probably started this journey in many different ways from all over the world and various different backgrounds. Studying at Edinburgh Napier University means you are a part of community and family. Edinburgh Napier University and ENSA are proud to be home to such a diverse culture of students with passion, courage, ambition, and determination. Dear graduates, remember, education is the key, knowledge is a power. So you have done your very best for your future path. Today, you have reached the finish line and you have walked across the stage to a future you have built and worked for. Once again, we are all so proud of your achievement. I want to take the time to thank some remarkable people who have been there to support you every step of the way. We all have that one member of staff who we know has gone above and beyond for us, who has inspired us, and who is the reason we are here today. I would like to thank all the academic staff at Edinburgh Napier University who have worked so hard to give you the best learning experience possible. So please give me a huge round of applause for all the teaching staff at Edinburgh Napier University. Furthermore, I also want to show our appreciation for hundreds of staff who don't stand in lecture halls, but are still just as important in our educational journey. We also owe our thanks to all the staff from school office, study skills, student hubs, cleaners, porters, accommodation, carriers, your ENSA, who are so important. There is also senior management at Edinburgh Napier University who all makes this possible, all the deans, directors, principal, and the university leadership team. Please, let's give a massive round of applause for all the staff at Edinburgh Napier University. Dear graduates, opportunity will never come to you. You have to create a platform for it. So the more you try, the more you push, the more you work hard, the more you challenge, you will reach your goal. If you say you can't do, then you can't do. If you say you can do, then you can do. Because the motivation motivated inside, you know, outside. Finally, it is... That's a good one. Thank you. Finally, it is time for you to face the big challengeable world, and you should be so proud of all your achievements. And remember, you will always have a home here at Edinburgh Napier University. Dear graduates, remember this. You're all the captains of our creative industry, scientists, tomorrow company directors, care professionals, parliamentarians, leader in innovation and education. So go forward and carry the name of Edinburgh Napier University and raise it higher. I wish you all the very best and congratulations to class of 2016. Thank you.
I'd like to add my welcome to that of David, our Chancellor, and to Rojan, the President of Edinburgh Napier Students Association. Welcome to all our newest graduates and to all your families and friends. And as Leslie said just a little while ago, graduation day is a really special day in the calendar of Edinburgh Napier University. Indeed, it is the highlight of our year. And though we do attend many graduations for staff, each one is particularly special and it is unique. And so I want to extend my very warmest congratulations to each of you, our newest graduates today. I also want to recognize those here today supporting you, your families and your friends. We all recognize that your journey today has not been a solo effort. And my own son graduated quite recently, and what a wonderful day it was. I wanted it to go on and on forever. I felt tremendous pride in his achievement, and also a little apprehension as well as excitement as he moved on to the next phase of his journey. And I know that all the people here supporting you today will feel a similar set of mixed emotions, for it is an occasion to be treasured and to be shared. I also want, along with Rojan, to thank my colleagues, the staff of the university, many of whom are here in the hall today and many who couldn't attend. Really, it's hard to put in words how they feel today, so I just sum it up as they're as proud as punch of you. I was reflecting over the last few days on my graduation ceremony a very long time ago, and while I do remember that sense of occasion, I cannot remember at all who spoke or what they said, which is not very encouraging when you're in my position there speaking to you this afternoon. So in that knowledge, I will be brief. And what I hope is that if not my words or my face remain with you, the essence of what I say will be with you for a little while as you leave the hall today. And the essence of what I believe is rooted in the role that I believe universities play in shaping societies. 3 years ago, just before I took on the role of principal of this wonderful university, I considered this quite deeply. I have since led Edinburgh Napier University on the basis that universities, which have a key role in creating knowledge and educating individuals, are fundamentally important to developing in their graduates, in the words of John Henry Newman, a 19th century scholar, the general powers of the mind. And through their graduates, universities are consequently a force for social cohesion, for prosperity, and for well-being. And we are gathered here today at a time when we have never needed universities and their graduates more. Much is at stake. From the many comments from pundits in the media worldwide, to the very conversations in our own homes between our families and friends, we ask ourselves, what is going on? What is happening in the world? The tumultuous state of UK politics at our time, our new journey as the UK voted to leave the European Union without a destination in mind, terrible wars in the Middle East, climate-related famine in Africa, a refugee crisis in Europe, terrorists performing chilling acts of brutality and using new media to spread fear. It is quite bewildering. So these are remarkable and challenging times. And indeed, the connectivity of people around the world through technology means we are living through crisis on almost a daily basis. Now, none of us knows what the future may unfold, but what we absolutely need to guide us through are adaptable, resilient, thoughtful individuals who have been developed to think creatively and critically, to challenge the status quo and be imaginative. People who use evidence, reason, facts, and logic to formulate their views and to shape their actions. These are the general powers of the mind that Newman talked about over 200 years ago, and I believe they remain the bedrock of university education today. Here in Edinburgh Napier University, we maintain an unwavering commitment and dedication to educating our students in an environment where ideas thrive and new knowledge and advances are made through rigorous testing, challenge, critical evaluation and debate. As an outward-looking university, we are a vital player in a global system which is increasingly driven by knowledge, innovation and ideas, and we are a force of good. Together, university communities around the world have reached across borders and nations to tackle challenges, have unlocked and harnessed new knowledge to change the way we communicate, and have helped heal divisions and foster understanding through dialogue and debate. Such is the power and role of universities in our time. And you, our newest graduates, are well equipped to address challenges and shape the future. And my challenge for you today is that you use all you have gained throughout your university journey to make a difference to the communities in which you will live and work. You cannot control the nature of the world you will face, but you can control the attitude you bring to that world. Be courageous and be imaginative, as in many ways during your time here you have already demonstrated. I think of the veterinary nursing students who spend time in India helping train clinicians on hygiene and infection control, as well as improving the recognition and management of animal pain. I think of the students who've headed to the towns and villages around Mount Kilimanjaro to teach first aid. And I think of the recent success of our forensic biology students in the World Skills Competition. Whilst others among you have juggled families, illness, and jobs to complete your studies. With such talent, the world is undoubtedly at your feet. Many of you have come here today to Scotland from around the world to study with us, including many from the European Union countries. I am proud of the talent and diversity that you bring to our community. You have enriched us. For Edinburgh Napier, Edinburgh Napier University is a community of learning with a goal of personal and social as well as intellectual development. Bringing students of diverse backgrounds to learn from one another enacts that commitment. And in a world divided by difference, here in Edinburgh Napier University, we do our best, we strive to be united by it. And as this university looks to the future, we will continue to grow our international reach and to seek out and welcome students and staff from around the world who share our values to join us on our journey. And to all our graduates, be in no doubt, as you have benefited from your time here with us, so you have made this university a better place. You came here with unique qualities of your own, and as you learned from us, so we have learned from you. You leave us equipped with skills and attributes with, I hope, the general powers of the mind, and I hope also with a sense of responsibility and a strong desire to make a difference. I am truly excited by all you have to offer. I know I speak for all the staff when I say that we are proud to have you as our graduates. I hope that you feel a strong attachment to the university and also to the city of Edinburgh. Please do tell us about your progress, for your success is our success. Take pride in our achievements too. Speak with others of your time with us. And most of all, be a part of our future by staying connected as valued alumni. And finally, when looking for that unique graduation card for my son, I noted one, which kind of chimed with me as what I'd hoped for him, that said, "May each day be worthy of a story." So this is what I wish for each of you, and that your career is successful, fulfilling, and touched with adventure as well. Graduates of 2016, my warm congratulations. I wish you all the very best. Thank you.
We're now coming to a close, and this bit's not scripted. It's offered to each and every one of you with all sincerity and heartfelt, and echoing the words of the principal and Rohan, today you became part of this university's history, equally as much as we are. This university and those sitting in front of you, our faces will change, rightly so, with time. But hopefully the principles and the foundations of this university stay the same. You have trusted us with some of the most precious and important years of your life. And speaking on behalf of this university, I can offer our thanks. I would now like to declare this graduation ceremony closed, and please be upstanding for the academic process.